Hey, Lane, how are you today?
Oh, hi, Pat. I'm good. Are we not in the lab today?
No, not today, but we're still going to learn something. I want to talk to you about the asphalt mixture volumetric terms.
Asphalt has a volume. Can we crank it up to 11?
No. Volumetrics. It's a way that we measure the components in an asphalt mixture, especially if it's been compacted in a laboratory.
Like the three A's of asphalt?
Yes. Do you remember what they are?
Sure do. Asphalt mixtures are made of aggregate, asphalt binder, and air.
Great. Sometimes there's an additive in there, but you are absolutely correct. So when we say volumetrics, we're talking about the volumes and the masses in the asphalt mixture. And there's a very specific set of terms that we use, a nomenclature, to describe those different terms.
Is this the GMM and the GMB stuff?
It is. So G would stand for specific gravity. And we use V for volume, we use M for mass, and P for percentage.
G, V, M, and P. Okay.
Okay, then we use subscripts as well. So in the subscript place, we would use M for mixture, we would use B for binder, we would use S for aggregate.
Wait, why S for aggregate? Why not A?
Because we need A for air. So aggregate and stone, we use the S like it would be stone.
Okay, I can see that.
And then we have the second subscript. In the second subscript place, we use things like M for maximum, B for bulk, A for absorbed, and E for effective.
It's starting to look like alphabet soup in my head, Pat.
It's not lunchtime yet, but I totally understand. When someone first learns about asphalt volumetric terms, it gets really confusing. After a while, you're able to speak the language naturally.
Okay. So
you mentioned GMM before. That's the specific gravity of the mixture maximum, or more commonly known as the maximum specific gravity of the mixture. So any guesses on what GMB is?
Well, G is specific gravity.
Mm-hmm.
The M is mixture.
Good.
And the B in the second place is bulk. So that's what we would call the bulk specific gravity.
Great. So some of the other more common terms that we use as well would be VA, which would be the volume of air or the air voids. We use PB for the percentage of binder, or PBE for the percentage of binder effective.
Wait up. Isn't all binder effective?
It's not. So some of the binder gets sucked into the little cracks and crevices of the aggregate, and then it can't be used to stick the particles together. But that's something I want to get into in detail later.
Okay. Test me again.
All right, what about the GSB?
Okay, G is specific gravity, the S is stone, and the B is bulk. So that would be the bulk specific gravity of the aggregate.
Great, sounds like you've got it. So here's a list of some other volumetric terms that I want to see if you can figure these out.
Ooh, like a quiz.
Yeah, I guess.